Hi, I'm Nicholeen Peck, and I teach communication, parenting, and family relationships. And in this video, we're going to be talking about how to teach your child conversation skills. Some children are natural talkers and they can talk with anybody about anything. They just open right up. But I know that there are many people who are a little bit more reserved. They maybe don't have that gift of gab that some people seem to be born with. And so we worry that they're going to be unsuccessful in some of their future relationships and endeavors, because we all know that conversation skills and good communication actually are some of the keys to our success. So how do we teach our children good conversation skills? Well, that's what we're going to be talking about in this video. I'm going to be sharing with you 5 tips for teaching your children good conversation skills, and if you stick with me all the way to the end, I've got a bonus for you too. Number 1 is example. So I want you to examine yourself. How good are you at conversation skills? Do you sometimes end up with these awkward conversations where you don't know what to say or what to do next? Do you have a tendency to avoid talking to people and going off on your own? Well, then that's what your child's gonna do too. But if, conversely, you're the type of person that likes to go up and look at a person and engage with them and have a good conversation with them, then your child is gonna learn that that's part of growing up. That's part of becoming older, and they'll think it's a safe thing for them to learn too. So make sure you are setting a good example. That good example is going to go much further than any of the other tips that I share with you in this video. Number 2, teach your child to value other people. So not just to think about themselves. Honestly, the more and more I work with families around the world and I hear their problems and answer their questions, the more selfishness that I am noticing, the more self-focus that people seem to be having. And that's parents and children, just to tell you. We need to value other people. How do we teach our children to value other people? So everyone can contribute something good to the world that they live in. Everyone has that potential. So what we need to do is we need to see other people as they are, not see them as we are, and compare them to what our strengths are. If we do that, then we immediately go to a judging place in our hearts and in our minds, and that closes us off to being able to have a good connection and conversation with them. So if you are trying to help anyone see your point of view or just get to know them, you've got to make sure that you come to them from a place of gratitude for who they are and valuing who they are. So the way that you teach a child this is when you get to know other people. Maybe their cousins come, maybe there's friends or neighbors, there's people at church or in the community that you happen to meet on a regular basis that might be different from you. What you do is you say, you know what, that person is different. Have you noticed that the way we do this and the way they do this are 2 different ways? Well, when you explain that to them and you say, you know, every person can find different ways to live their lives and do things. Each person is looking for what they hope to be the very best. We know that this is what we've planned for our family, but not every person is going to be exactly the same as us. And we can learn to love all different kinds of people, no matter how they are. So making sure that you prepare your child to reach out to others, while also, though, at the same time, maintaining discernment for what your family values, rules, and standards happen to be. So it is also okay to point out when somebody else has a different standard and that that might not be a healthy or appropriate standard for your child, and that they can learn to say no to that even though they can still value the person. I've got 3 more tips for you and a special bonus, but before I get to those, hit that subscribe button now, because you are not going to want to miss all the videos that come out on this channel related to you, your children, your relationships, and success for your lives. Tip number three is ask questions. So as you are setting the example with your children, be sure to ask them questions and allow them to respond without interrupting them. So make sure that you give them a chance to share their thoughts and discuss their thoughts with them. Then also explain when you're getting ready to go meet with other people that a really good thing for them to do is to ask those other people questions too. A person that gets to talk about themselves in a social communication always feels like things went well. So if you want your child to make good friends and to learn how to converse with people in a way that wins them friends and connections, then you want to teach them to turn a lot of that conversation toward the other person so that they can learn about them and give that other person a chance to have the limelight and the opportunity to talk. When they do that, they will actually feel good. They will feel charitable in that communication with the other person, and their connections and conversations with other people won't always be about them. So this is a great way to have the heart of your child turn toward the hearts of other people instead of just on themselves. Tip number four is to share about yourself. It's important for good conversation for a person to open up. There is nothing that kills conversation more than when a person doesn't share. They hold back. They protect their information about their lives. Now, obviously, there's some key things that are a little private, maybe, that a person might have, but the majority of our lives should be considered shareable, because when we do share those things, we get more help from other people. Sometimes just explaining something to someone puts things together in our brain that we actually didn't have connected before that conversation. So it can be beneficial to the hearer as well as to the speaker. So keep that in mind. Also, when a person is vulnerable, shares experiences, thoughts, beliefs, or opinions that they have with other people, that lets another person really know them better. I think as part of this share about yourself, we need to make sure that our children understand that you could hear something from someone that does not match you or your values. And it's okay. It's good that they're sharing those things with you so that you can know them better. This gives you a better idea of if you want to get to know that person more or not. You don't have to agree with every single person to have a good conversation. I wish people would get that. People shame each other, shun each other, bully each other just because there's differences. That makes it so it's not safe feeling to share something about yourself. We should feel like we can share things about ourselves and that other people will respect them because we're also respecting the things that we learn about them as well. Tip number five is teach the child how to disagree appropriately. This is important because sometimes when we have conversations with other people, we don't see eye to eye about things. So how are you going to discuss with a person, value a person, and have this ongoing connection with them when you don't see eye to eye? Well, there's a skill for that. In fact, it's one of the four basic skills that I teach in my Teaching Self-Government course, which you can find at teachingselfgovernment.com. That skill is disagreeing appropriately. When you disagree appropriately with another person, you look at the person, you keep a calm face, voice, and body. And then you say that you understand the other person's point of view, you share your point of view, you listen to what they have to say, and then you say, okay, that's what they think, right? You don't have to still agree, but you say, okay, that's what they think, and then you drop the subject, which means you don't harbor any bad feelings about it. You still maintain a connection and a value for the person, even if you do not agree on this particular topic. So what might that look like? It looks like this. I'm looking at the person, I'm keeping a calm face, voice, and body, and I say something like, I know that you think macaroni and cheese is the very best health food that there is, but I've been doing a little bit of research on health food myself, and I have found that salad far surpasses macaroni and cheese in health properties in these ways. And if the person says, okay, then you can say okay and drop the subject too inside your own mind and heart. But if the person says, nope, it's macaroni and cheese for sure, and they're gonna still argue with you about it, then you can say, okay, well, that's going to be, you know, what they're going to stick to. And then you drop the subject. You move on to a new conversation. All right, you stayed with me to the end. Are you ready for the bonus? So here is the bonus, and that is practice or role play. If you want your child to be really good at conversations with other people, they need to have a lot of practice time where they're talking back and forth with you and with other people. So make sure that you know when they are a child, that whole time of their life is about practice. And so if they fail in a certain situation, no big deal. It was a practice. Let's talk about what happened, prepare for next time so that it can be better. But also do staged or cued role plays where you just say, hey, we're going to go meet with new friends and we're going to have to introduce ourselves and start talking about things. Let's practice what that might look like. Now also prepare them in these practices that it could take a turn a little bit differently than what you've practiced for. But those practices are going to give them confidence, decrease their anxiety, and prepare them to have the words to say when the time comes to say those words. So, do you think you're ready? Can you teach your child good conversation skills? I hope so. This is a great start. But if you would like to learn more self-government skills that are going to transform your life and the lives of your children, I recommend my next video, which is The Expectation Trap versus The Cycle for Success. That video is going to be a transformative video that will teach you what you need to do to stop falling into those traps that take your relationships and your conversations at home or anywhere else on a downward spiral. Click that link now and I will see you there.